Now it is time for us to discuss with our last guest, and we have Uyoyou Adia, a filmmaker, scriptwriter, and director with such amazing projects such as Lost, hashtag The Fourth Side to her credit, and also the writer of Nneka, The Pretty Serpent. Now, The Fourth Side has gone to win awards both globally and locally. Now, she's joined us for a chat, and let's talk to her. Morning.
Good morning.
Good to have you here.
Thank you for having me.
I mean, I want to start my conversation with talking about Nneka, The Pretty Serpent. I want to know, how did it start for you, getting the job as the writer?
First, I want to say thank you for having me. Oh. And for Nneka, The Pretty Serpent, it was really more of one of my mentors at the time, okay. Mr. Chris Ode. He actually called me to write the project. Like, oh. I was part of the story development team.
Okay.
But then he called that I was the one that was going to write it. It was scary. It was very scary, but we wrote it. It has come out.
Yeah.
It's coming on Netflix soon, so.
So when you say we wrote it, did you write it alongside someone, or were you the sole writer of the project?
I was, and I am the sole writer of Nneka, The Pretty Serpent.
Fabulous.
Yeah.
Could you quickly run us through your creative process? I mean, it must have been a lot of pressure considering that there was a prequel to that, and the fear of your story matching the previous story. How was the whole creative process for you?
So that was, it was in the heat of COVID, right?
Okay.
So we had a lot of time. I think we spent like six months thereabout developing Nneka, The Pretty Serpent, and
okay.
writing Nneka, The Pretty Serpent. I had to watch the old one
okay.
to know what this new one was going to be about and how it was going to go.
Hmm.
Though it didn't really influence the new one,
okay.
right? We just took some certain elements from the
from
old
it.
One to make this new one happen,
mm-hmm.
right? So we did the story breakdown. We all had meetings, myself, Mr. Chris, the director, Tosin Ego,
yeah.
Baruch, Umpo, yeah, and I think Omotunde, yeah. You know, we did the story development, did the scene breakdown, and then I started the writing process.
Okay.
So each draft I wrote, we had a meeting on each draft. Mm. We went through it thoroughly
yeah.
before we sent it out to the script editor.
Okay. Now, yeah. as a writer now, just beyond Nneka now, as a writer generally, how well would you say how well do you handle criticisms of your work?
Oof, it was hard at first.
Okay.
It was very, even with Nneka, like when I did the first draft, I was like, yo, I've done this shit. Like, this is it.
Mm-hmm.
Then I got reviews and it humbled me.
Wow.
It humbled me.
What would you say was the hardest review you've ever had?
Dialoguing. It was the dialogues. It was like, who talks like this? Nobody talks like this. Why did you write this? Like, it was hard. Like, it was, I think at a point I was saying I wasn't going to write it anymore because it was hard. I keep telling myself, writing Nneka is writing school for me because I went through that process. You can't even critique my work right now. That is bad, and I will cry anymore. It's not even possible.
Yeah.
Like, I've gone through that phase already.
Okay.
Right now, I take criticism as something that I didn't think about.
Okay.
I should think about it maybe
okay.
next time.
Next time.
Or if I have an opportunity to
yeah.
do it now, I do
mm-hmm.
it now. If
okay.
it works well for me, fine. If it doesn't work well for me, I filter it. That's how it works now.
Okay, so let's move on to Rattlesnake. You are an assistant director on
yes,
Rattlesnake.
Yes, our second assistant director.
Yeah. Now, what's the role of a second assistant director?
Basically, is to make the first assistant director's job easy.
Okay.
So the first assistant director is always with the director, right? Planning
okay.
the shot and all that. I, on the other hand, I'm making sure the actors are ready. I'm making sure the actors have their lines. I'm making sure they're in costume, makeup. Whatever it is that is going wrong with production,
yeah.
I should know so
okay.
that I can inform, you know, the first AD.
Yeah.
He has the final say, but I need to know all these things. Who is running late? Who is not running late?
Okay.
I also have to do the call sheets for the production or for the scenes that we have to shoot day by day.
Oh,
yeah.
Okay. Now, so progressing from a script writer to an assistant director and now to a director, I mean, you have Charge and Bail with Ink Blots to your
Yay.
Belt. You have the hashtag
fourth side.
Now, how did you transition to this level, and at what point in your career did you feel like I want to move, or at what point did you feel like I want to this is where I now want to be?
Right. So coming into the industry, I always knew I wanted to be a director.
Okay.
Right. I've always known that, and writing was also something I was doing on the side.
Okay.
So being a second AD was a way of coming into the industry, okay. understanding how production works, understanding how set life works, so that when it's time for me to do my stuff, it's not going to be difficult, per se, right? So it wasn't really so much of a transition for me. It was just the timing. The timing was just right. Okay. Everything I had to do, the timing was right. As at the time I was second AD for some jobs, I was also writing.
Okay.
And I also first AD'd. Do you understand? So directing, I was also directing at the time. So it was all, you know, intertwined with each other. Okay. Again, it was just the right time for certain things to happen.
Okay, now I want to talk about your lows as a director. I mean, you, Charge and Bail is your first cinema director. So it's going to be your directorial debut on in the cinemas.
Yes.
Now, how was it like for you? Was there any point where you doubted yourself or doubted your takes?
So with Charge and Bail, first of all, shout out to Inkblot for having me on Charge and Bail. Charge and Bail was... I had all the doubts before I went on set.
Okay.
So it was constant struggle with myself. It was constant, do you really want to do this? Is this where you want to be and all of that? If they don't like your film, what are you going to do and all that? Mm-hmm. But I think a week to shoot, I literally shut down. Like, I literally had a one-on-one conversation with myself. I'm like, it's now or never, right? If you're not going to do it, someone else is going to do it. So take your chance and be proud of it. Whatever the outcome is, mm-hmm. be proud of it. You have done it.
Okay.
That's how I went into Charge and Bail.
I want to go a bit personal now. As a creative, it's hard for people to see your personal struggles because we're always happy and bubbly. And I do remember that you lost your mom between the period of when Nneka the Pretty Serpent came out.
Yeah.
Now, how have you been able to manage your... Because on social media, you did express how close both of you were. How have you been able to manage such a loss and still go on to create and not lose your spark?
Honestly, I don't know. I don't know. I actually do not know. All I can say is... my family has been a major source of support, you know, and strength. So, I don't know. That's all I can say.
Oh, okay. Well, we do hope that you do get your spark back up.
Yeah.
But now, talking about the industry and as a director, you know how you're very optimistic about a film coming, and then it comes out and people start to bash it on social media.
Yeah.
Now, what do you think is... it's missing when things like that come out? Because sometimes, let's assume that a project came out and people start to bash it, and in that moment, you see the errors. So what do you think was missing that it wasn't seen before it came out?
So art is very subjective, right? I might have the perfect script right now, and it's not perfect to you, right? I like to say in my head that the audience or everybody is sort of like a writer or a director because they like to tell you what they would have done differently, what they wouldn't have done and all of that. But at the end of the day, you have to go with your guts. Mm. If that is what you think works for you, I promise you, if you send that script to 100 people, 100 people will have different notes on that script. So at the end of the day, you are not really following what you want to do.
Okay.
You are just going to be getting notes
on what people.
Exactly.
Okay.
So, like I said, again, that was how I went into Charge and Bail. You are here. Do it the way you know how to.
Okay.
You learn from the process at the end of the day.
All right.